Hello again, and this is Klaus from electronics.unmesh. In the last video, I presented the concept for a stylish display instrument with a stepper motor. Today, I will explain to you how the electronics hardware is set up. We want to build a display instrument with a stepper motor that can be used universally. For this, we made a high-level concept using a block diagram in the last video. We also defined the features we want to have. If you haven't seen the video at the top right, I'd like to recommend it because it explains all the features. I'm using an Arduino Nano for the project, which is relatively cheap. But you could use almost any other Arduino board on which you might want to run additional programs and additional hardware features like WiFi or LoRa. I want to receive an analog signal with the Arduino. For this, I use the analog input A0. You could also receive digital data instead. I will show you how to do that in a later video. For now, however, we will stick to the example with the analog input. In our concept, we have defined that we want to adjust the resonance frequency and the damping of our digital filter with potentiometers. Therefore, we connect two trimmers as a variable voltage divider and we feed the voltages to the inputs A1 and A2. We do exactly the same for the zero adjust, the brightness for the LED lighting and for the gain. We connect the trimmers to the inputs A3, A4 and A5 accordingly. It's definitely a good idea to stabilize the DC voltages with capacitors, because the Arduino generates current spikes that could interfere here. To stabilize slow voltage ripples, I built in a 50 microfarad electrolytic capacitor. Rapid ripples are reduced by ceramic capacitors, each with a capacitance of 10 nanofarads. The coils of the stepper are connected to the digital outputs D11, D10, D9 and D8. We can do this because our stepper motor coils each have a resistance of around 250 ohms. 5 volts divided by 250 ohms is only 20 milliamps of current. An Arduino is capable to deliver this current directly from a digital output. However, it is advisable to install flyback diodes to avoid the voltage peaks that occur when the current is switched off at the coils. Without these diodes, the voltage spikes would probably destroy the Arduino over time. Okay, now we're almost done. And the only thing missing is the dimmable lighting, which we implement via pulse width modulation at output D6. The two white LEDs run quite well over a 290 ohms series resistor. In this case, each of the LEDs draws about 9 milliamps maximum. The brightness is sufficient for my purpose. With pulse width modulation, we can then dim the brightness of the LEDs down to zero. In case you need more brightness, you could use multiple outputs and multiple LEDs. These could even be controlled separately in order to implement other interesting functions. But that's just a side note. I will show you later how to do it. Yes, it's really worth staying tuned in. It's best to subscribe the channel right away. As always, I tested a lot on the breadboard. In this phase, it turns out whether my ideas really work and whether the concept is resilient. I test the software and the hardware at the same time, before finally building the circuit on a printed board. I'm using a geek board to build the circuit, as I need some space for the 5 trimmers. And the board doesn't use space very efficiently, since it has pretty much the same connections as a breadboard, but it is of good quality and it fits perfectly for my purpose. If you want to save space, you could use a smaller Arduino board and replace the trimmers with fixed values in the code. I show you now the wiring of the pins for the X27 stepper motor. No big deal. If you use trimmers in this project, then it's worth creating such an image so that you don't later confuse the various parameters. It is best to stick the picture next to the circuit board. Then we take a look on the backside of our case. Inside you can see the sockets to fix the printed board with screws. The holes for the screws are spaced 46 mm by 85 mm. So, what's coming next? We need to talk about the software in the coming video. It's not particularly complicated, but I think it will be useful if I explain it. Then we will talk about the casing. I spent really a lot of effort into constructing it, because I wanted to have a stylish design. Of course, I will talk about some applications, like acoustic signals for example. See you next time! Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.